Hello friends, in our last video we have seen 80386 signals. What are the different groups of signals that your 80386 processor provides? The pin diagram of 80386 also we have seen. Now our today's topic is 80386 system clock. Now what is the system clock? The internal processor clock or P clock or processor clock is responsible for synchronizing the internal as well as external bus operations of the 80386 processor. That we called as system clock, means it is your processor's own clock for the synchronization of internal and external bus operations. Now this processor operates at the different clock frequencies or different clock speed. Here it is shown 80386DX16, means at this 16 megahertz frequency it can operate. The speed of processor is 16 megahertz. For 20, the speed is 20 megahertz, and 25 megahertz, and 33 megahertz. The clock signal that is applied to the clock 2 input of the 80386DX is twice the internal processor clock frequency of the microprocessor. Therefore, this clock 2 of the processor 16 is driven by a 32 megahertz signal. Now this is your system clock, which operates at different clock speeds. Here is the frequencies of the clock speed is given. Now moving to the next topic, bus cycles and bus states. This is again very important topic from your exam point of view. Now what is bus cycle? A bus cycle is the activity performed by the microprocessor to access data from memory or IO devices. Means with the help of this bus cycle, processor can access the data from the memory or any kind of input output devices. Now what is bus state? The bus state is defined as the shortest time of the activity of the processor bus, means the shortest time of the processor bus. It is one processor clock period in duration. The internal processor clock signal, that is P clock, processor clock, is the half of the frequency of the external clock input signal. We can see the diagram. Here is the diagram. It shows that the processor clock period, here it is, that is T1. Processor clock period is T1, and clock 2 period is Phi1 and Phi2, means it's half of the processor clock period, this clock 2. And here we can see the internal processor's clock, that means P clock. From this figure we can see that the internal processor clock signal is the half the frequency of the external clock input signal. Yes, it is shown in the figure. Now this clock 2 input of 80386 processor provides the fundamental timing. It is divided by 2 internally to generate the internal processor clock, that is used for the instruction execution. The internal clock is divided into 2 phases, that is phi 1 and phi 2. These are the two phases of this internal clock. Each clock 2 period is a phase of internal clock, like this. For example, in a 20 megahertz 80386 DX system, clock 2 frequency equals to 40 megahertz. That means each clock cycle has a duration of 25 nanoseconds, like this. And the processor clock period is twice the internal clock period, that is 50 nanoseconds. Like this, this diagram says that two phases, that is phi 1 and phi 2 of the processor cycle, contribute as one processor clock period, right? This two phases contribute as processor one clock period, like this. Now, each bus cycle has two states, T1 and T2. This T1 and T2 are states of the bus cycle. Now, each state has two phases or two clock cycle. This each phase has two clock cycle. This T1 is having two clock cycle. T2 is also having two clock cycle. In the first state, T1 addresses and bus status pins are active. While in the second phase, state T2, the data transfer will occur. Means at this T1 state, address and bus status are active. Address pins and bus status pins are active. And in the second phase, means in T2, the actual data transfer will occur. The clock signal that is applied to the clock 2 input of 80386 is twice the frequency of the microprocessor. Here we can see. Therefore, this clock 2 of an 80386 is driven by a 32 megahertz of signal, and this signal must be generated externally. Now, if the processor does not need any bus cycle, it remains in the TI. TI is the idle state. Means processor is not working, it is in idle state, that is your TI state. Here we can see the diagram. TI is the idle state, means no bus cycle is required. Processor does not need any bus cycle, that means idle. That phase is your TI phase. This TI phase indicates that no bus cycle is currently being processed. This cycle starts after a software reset. Now, bus state T1 and T2, here we can see T1 and T2 are first and second bus states of the bus cycle. Now, this is the diagram for bus state transition diagram. TI indicates that processor is idle, or it is idle state, means no bus cycle is required for the processor. Now, whether there is a new bus cycle started, it transfers the control to the further state, that is T1. This is shown in the T1. Here it is shown and T2. Now, ready activated, request pending, then it will execute. And after T2 stage, when the bus cycle completes and no new request is there, then the control will passes to the TI, means
processor is idle, no bus cycle is requested, means processor will be idle. The control pass to the TI state.
Moving to the next topic, that is 80386DX bus cycles. Now we have seen the bus cycle is the activity that is done by the microprocessor so that it can access data from the memory or IO devices. Now the internal as well as external bus operations of 80386 processor are synchronized with the clock signal. Clock signal helps to synchronize the internal and external operations of the 80386 processor. This processor supports 7 types of bus cycles. Here we can see the types of bus cycle. First one is your interrupt acknowledge bus cycle, then memory read cycle, memory write cycle, input output read cycle, IO write cycle, then instruction fetch cycle, and halt or shutdown cycle. Now depending on this bus cycle, the respective status signals are activated. We are having the table for those status signals. This is the bus cycle definition. Now in the table we can see that when your memory or IO is at low, data and control is at low, read write is at low, that means interrupt acknowledgement bus cycle is there and locked is activated. Likewise, when idle is activated, when IO data read, when IO data write, all the conditions are shown in the table. For IO operations, it is low, whereas for memory related operations, MIO is high. The DC signal when low indicates that a control signal, and when high indicates a data signal. We have seen it in the earlier topic. Again, the read-write signal indicates a read cycle. If read-write is low, and it indicates write when the read-write is low. Again, the lock signal is used to differentiate between the locked and unlocked bus cycles. These signals are generally valid after the EDS signal is activated. To indicate a valid bus cycle, the processor asserts the EDS signals active low. When the 80386 bus control signals comprise 3-4 kinds of signal, we have seen these bus control signals: EDS pin, ready pin, next address pin, and this BS16 pin. Now this is all about the bus cycles of 80386 processor.